Hey everyone, Jinx here. So as you probably know, I've been dealing with a lot these past few months. My mental state has not been at its prime and I have really struggled to keep up with producing content for y'all. And honestly, the whole situation going on in the world right now isn't exactly helping that. Well, after a lot of deliberation and working with a therapist, I've come to realize some things and I think it's important to let you, our community, know what's going on and why I haven't been playing Monster Hunter World or making any videos about it. But first off though, just to clarify for anyone who's new to the channel, Monster Hunter World and its expansion Iceborne are phenomenal games that I have spent over 2,000 hours playing. Capcom is a fantastic company and has continued to give us free content ever since the expansion released 9 months ago, and I highly recommend the game to anyone looking to pick it up because it's extremely fun. I love this game, I love this community, which is the best gaming community I have ever been a part of, and I am so thankful to this game for enabling Tuna and I to start and grow this channel. However, it isn't perfect, and I need to air my grievances about Iceborne specifically and explain why I haven't been making any videos. Simply put, I've realized that I've just lost all of my passion for Monster Hunter World. There's two big reasons for this. The first is that I have over 2,000 hours in this game at this point, and I've just completely lost interest. I literally have as much time in this one game as I have in the entire Souls series, which was previously my most played games. There isn't any more math to crunch on the game that I care to crunch, and there isn't anything left for me to learn that I care about learning. My insatiable desire to learn, analyze, and improve is one of my primary driving forces for my interest in anything. I genuinely struggle to play the game for more than an hour at a time at this point because it just feels like I am running through the motions. I don't even crunch the math on the meta sets anymore. We have a fantastic team of set optimizers in our community that math out the meta sets each patch. They are so fast at it that when they work out the new meta sets, it's before I've even finished my first impressions video for each new patch. Which, real talk, is something I'm very thankful for because I'm just kind of bored of meta set math. I guess in summary of this first point, I'm just burnt out on Monster Hunter World. Every time recently that new content has come out, I've really only been excited about it for a day or two, and I think I've just run my course with this game. Don't get me wrong, when Alatreon does eventually come out, I will be making videos about the fight and new gear and sets, but that'll only maintain my interest for maybe a week. The second reason is that I'm just not a huge fan of how Iceborne plays, and I know for a fact I am not alone in this sentiment. However, to clarify on this point, I'm not saying that I dislike the weapon moveset changes. One of our most viewed videos from month to month is my video professing my adoration for the Switch Axe moveset changes in Iceborne. And I stand by everything I said in that video. So many weapons got so much more fun to play in Iceborne thanks to the moveset additions and adjustments and tweaks. The two things that make me dislike how Iceborne plays are the Clutch Claw and the Master Rank Monster AI. Let's start with the Clutch Claw. I like the Clutch Claw in theory. The idea of being able to wallbang the monsters and manipulate their positioning is something I am a huge fan of. I even like the idea of softening a monster in theory. I remember being excited about softening when they announced it in the Iceborne trailers. I hate the implementation of softening in Iceborne. Instead of making softening feel like a buff to your damage by letting you manipulate hits and values on a monster, they made it feel like you are punished and debuffed unless you soften. This may sound like the same thing, but it's a very important distinction. Monsters across the board in Master Rank have lower hits and values compared to pre-Iceborne base game. Unless you soften a monster's hit zone, you often don't even get a weak point on the monster at all. And that's fully aside from the fact that Weakness Exploit is now weaker unless you're hitting a softened weak point, which not only impacts your damage but adds RNG as a factor because you drop below 100% affinity, and that ends up affecting your sharpness. Simply put, it feels like if you do not soften a monster weak point regularly and keep hitting only that, you are just straight up punished, you're hitting trash zones the entire time. Conversely, if the hits and values were close to or the same as base games and all softening did was allow you to deal more damage to a specific body part, it would feel like a buff. Instead, the way it's implemented right now, it just feels like you're punished for not doing it, and it's basically mandatory to soften and keep softening up, which is also not that reasonable, but more on that in a second. For so many reasons that I'll be getting into, softening just doesn't feel fun. It feels like an anti-fun mechanic. And the biggest reason why it feels so anti-fun is that softens only last 90 seconds. And on top of that, the only optimal and safe time to soften a monster is during a clagger. This places the pressure of trying to maintain damage pressure on the monster in the correct parts to get a clagger within 90 seconds after your initial soften. There are some weapon to monster matchups that even speedrunners can struggle to maintain these softens because of this time limit. And for us more casual players, this is even worse because of monster AI, because you and I both know monsters can love to waste your time. There are some runs where monsters just decide to burn 30 seconds without you ever interacting with it. Tigrex and the Diabloses being the obvious examples. There are few things as frustrating to me as watching a monster waste a third of my softening time with me literally being able to not do anything about it. I hate uninteractive gameplay in video games, and Iceborne just makes it so much worse. 90 seconds is just too tight a time limit for even competent players to keep up softens, let alone more casual players who prefer to play more defensively. It strikes me as strangely contradictory that Iceborne is designed to be more punishing to defensive players, considering how Monster Hunter World is Capcom's attempt at a broader appeal. And if that 90 second timer runs out, well, your only option to re-soften is to just straight up YOLO a soften on a monster. Softens can take upwards of 5 seconds, that's longer than most weapons' strongest burst combos. I can count on one hand how many monsters give you a real, readable, guaranteed opening after an attack long enough to get a soften off. Outside of those, you just have to YOLO it. It's a literal flip of a coin whether you'll get the soften off. I like calculated, deliberate decision making in games and being rewarded and punished for that. I don't like game mechanics that force me to flip a coin. And yes, you can soften a monster during a trip or when they're stunned or things like that, but that is objectively worse than just actually doing damage to the monster during that down duration. This 90 second timer on the softening and being able to get very few softens in other than just refreshing that one body part also removes the consistency of combat strategies that focus on damaging two parts. Before Iceborne, an extremely effective strategy for fighting the entire Wrath family was to damage their legs to force a trip and then use the opening to damage their much weaker heads. There were many variations on how to do this. For example, you could do one combo on the legs during the trip to build up a second trip, then focus on the head. This way you can both have a leg trip mostly built up and also have a head dunk prepped in case they start flying. But because softening both a leg and a head is unrealistic without YOLOing a soften or running a mantle, the damage on one body part is inconsistent from run to run because of crit RNG. For example, if you soften a Rathalos's heads, anytime you hit its legs, you aren't guaranteed to do the same damage because you aren't at 100% crit. This just takes control away from the player and makes it feel bad and punishing. It just feels like I cannot work towards truly mastering those matchups because now they're adding this crit RNG on top of the already existing RNG that existed in runs. Speaking of RNG, let's talk about Monster AI RNG in Iceborne. It is a horrible feeling to feel like you were punished for no other reason than the RNG of a monster's AI decided to fuck with you. Both regular and Black Diablos were fantastic fights pre-Iceborne. Sure, they did dig sometimes and have uninteractive charges, but they gave you openings to fight back. But the Master Rank AI is atrocious unless you run a shield weapon. I have had multiple instances where I literally don't get to attack a Master Rank Black Diablos from the moment she enters an area until she leaves. Master Rank Black Diablos is so bad that it made me pick up Shield Heavy Bowgun non-ironically. It was out of necessity because I needed Black Diablos parts and I didn't have any way to farm it in a non-frustrating way other than abusing the most broken mechanic and weapon in the game. I honestly just didn't want to spend 20 minutes hunting a Black Diablos and spend 70% of the time not doing anything. Sure, sometimes she might have okay AI, but in pre-Iceborne, the Black Diablos never forced me to not attack for 5 minutes straight. And I'm just not interested in flipping a coin every time I load into a hunt whether it's gonna be that or a half-decent fight. These kinds of uninteractive AI possibilities are even worse in Iceborne because softens only last 90 seconds. Suddenly, you're not interacting with a monster, but you're also watching your soften timer run down. Not to mention, I'm a Switch Axe main, meaning I get to watch my own power axe or sword amped timers run down while all of this is happening. Tuna even had a Master Rank Lunastra that supernova'd 3 times in one area, and yes, he never flashed her. Now, while lots of monster AI have gotten more punishing and less fun in Iceborne, the most notable group to me is the Flyers. I loved fighting Flyers in base Monster Hunter World. And yes, I do mean without ever using flash pods. The challenge of prepping dunks and sniping monsters out of the air with well-calculated damage counting, positioning, and timing was one of my favorite things to do in the game. I've killed well over 500 Rathaloses in base Monster Hunter World just for the challenge of dunking them with different weapons. Even with dual blades, you could consistently dunk a Rathalos if you played the matchup right. Iceborne ruined this anti-air gameplay. First off, in base game you had a thing called a head dunk prep, which is where you dodge the roar on a monster and then deal damage to its head while it's roaring before it flies off. This would prep the dunk on a monster, so you only had to hit the head a few times to knock them out of the air. You can no longer do this because you have to soften. Not to mention, your soften damage to the head isn't consistent because of crit RNG, meaning it may mess with your damage counts. A sign of mastery over a flyer matchup in base Monster Hunter World was a perfectly calculated and timed frame dunk, where you dunk a monster out of the air the frame they take to the air. And as far as I'm aware, that is just no longer a thing. But more importantly, flyer AI is just fucked. Monsters that had patterns previously no longer really have patterns, and there's also this consistent issue where they suddenly decide to fly around at a much higher elevation. So high that I can't even tickle their heads with a Switch Axe upswing, one of the highest reaching attacks in the game. Now, this might be okay if it was only for one attack or two, but I've had Rathaloses maintain this high altitude for 5 attacks in a row regularly. I cannot stress how much I hate uninteractive gameplay. And I admit that it feels personal to me that one of my favorite things in base game, anti-air combat, became so bad in Iceborne. And yes, I know I can just flash pod them out of the air. But in base game, you had the choice of either flashing them for an easy drop, or you could dunk them out of the air to get a very long rewarding down out of it. You had the more challenging option and were more strongly rewarded for taking that option. That high skill option simply got ruined in Iceborne. This is further exacerbated by the fact that your soften timer is running down the entire time you're waiting for this Rathalos to drop down a bit. So you're being even further punished for trying to do the high skill play, and this punishment is entirely out of your control. It's just another flip of the coin. And I know I'm not alone in feeling this way about Iceborne in general. I can name at least 20 speedrunners who feel the same way about softening an AI in Iceborne. Many of them straight up quit playing Iceborne and doing speedruns because of these things. The amount of resets that a speedrunner has to do to get a good time is already insane, but adding these extra coin flips to the mix just makes it so much less fun for them. It just makes it feel so much more punishing trying to master a matchup. To clarify, I don't think Clutch Claw is a bad idea, I think the implementation is bad. I think the 90 second timer on softens is bad implementation. I think Klagger's feeling inconsistent and also being able to eat your trips is bad implementation. I think hits and values being dropped across the board so it feels like you are punished for not softening instead of getting buffed by softening is bad implementation. I think technical weapons needing 2 hits to soften so they are forced to YOLO a second softening attack is bad implementation. I think having only select technical weapons having 1 hit softens is bad implementation. I think having softens take so long you're forced to YOLO them unless it's during a Klagger is bad implementation. Again, Monster Hunter World Iceborne is a fantastic game and I've spent over 500 hours just playing the expansion. If you're wondering if it's worth playing, it absolutely is. You'll easily get hundreds of hours of fun gameplay out of it. However, it isn't perfect, and I need to air these grievances I and the community have with the game. Which brings us full circle to the first point. This is why I haven't been making any videos about Monster Hunter. I've lost all of my passion for the game, and I genuinely struggle to even start working on a script for a meta video these days, much less make a full video. I have had the full script and half of the audio done for the Raging Bracky Part 2 video for like 2 months now. It's become so bad mentally and emotionally that I have been feeling that I would rather just go back to high-end restaurant work and consulting rather than make a new meta video for the channel. I've been working with a therapist for several months now and just realized that making videos about something I have lost all of my passion for just doesn't work and isn't good for my mental health. So, moving forward, I'm only going to be making videos about things that interest me and that I am passionate about. A lot of content creators say you should make content that excites you because otherwise your viewers won't enjoy it. Well, that's just what I'm going to have to do if this channel is going to continue to exist. This doesn't necessarily exclude Monster Hunter World. When Alatreon comes out, I'll be sure to cover the parts of it that do interest me. And I do have some Monster Hunter World related video ideas that do interest me. One example would be a video discussing the various speedrun weapon class rankings. Hint, hint, the longsword is not nearly as high as your longsword main friends might think it would be. But what this does mean is I'll be making videos about other games and topics that I am passionate about. Recently, that has honestly been Valorant and the weapon math, strategy, and meta involved with the game. I played the ever-loving shit out of the beta, and I'm also relatively new to FPSs and especially tactical shooters, so there has been so much fascinating stuff that I've been getting to learn and test. With the full release of the game coming June 2nd, I'll likely be making several videos related to it. Now, if this change does drop our income enough that I have to pick up a job and work less on videos, so be it. I've realized that I just can't work on video topics I just have zero passion for, and the channel won't survive if I try to force myself to do that anyway. I hope that some of you will enjoy this new direction and the new content I'll be putting out, and I thank every single one of you who chooses to support us in this new transition. And for those of you who won't be interested in our new content, thank you so much for your support over this past year and a half. It's been an amazing journey with you all, and we couldn't have done what we did without you. We actually managed to hit 100,000 subs in under 2 years, which is staggeringly fast for YouTube. You guys have all been amazing, and I really wish I could keep just burning out meta videos and Monster Hunter World content like you deserve. But I just honestly can't. I've just realized I have to make content that I care about and I'm passionate about, or I just won't be making content at all. And even though I likely won't be making any new meta videos, don't worry because literally every possible meta set is on our Discord server. Thank you again to our amazing set optimizer team for putting all of those meta set albums together, and be sure to check the description of this video for a link to the Discord server. And speaking of support, I do want to give a shout out to all of our patrons. So a huge thank you to Foray, Zige, XCLK07, Yoshi Cho, Fly T, David Sternberg, Laydell Wilson, Bird Lord, Sinful by Nature, Flagoblast, PB Livingston, John Cohen, Warren Kios, Hensatsuken, Aaron Fakar, Colby Alexander, Lix, Tito Bobito, Wolf Steel, Starlord 1845, Andrew Ferruria, Luna Lee, 0412, Levi Wheeler, Dive2World, Blackie, Razlek, Drew, Vorpal Prybar, Samantha Falcon, Overheat, Jason BKX, Sweet Daddy, DMKR, Benjamin, Matthew Gordon, Cody Taylor, EAYR, Fancy, Lord K2, Scott Dobros, Mally, Captain Walmart, Sir Kite, Kumiko, Papa Slatch, Alan O'Dom, Zimv, Jamie, Milky Powder, Skylar Yang, and every single one of you who supports us on Patreon. It means so much that you've been willing to support us during this time, especially considering how much I've been struggling with actually making any kind of a video. So thank you so much again. And who knows, when Capcom releases their next Monster Hunter game, maybe I'll be diving in headfirst into the math and testing of the game. But only time can tell. Happy hunting, hunters. Thank you all so much for your support and everything you've done for us. See you soon. Bye.